In the 1870s, the federal government, partly in order to meet its obligations to educate Aboriginal children, began to play a role in the development and administration of these schools. Two primary objectives of the residential school system were to remove and isolate children from the influence of their home, families, traditions, and cultures, and to assimilate them into the dominant culture. These objectives were based on the assumption that Aboriginal cultures and spiritual beliefs were inferior and unequal. Indeed, some saw it, as was infamously said, to kill the Indian in the child.
But I'm still alive and I will not die. I'ma do the impossible, learning to fly. With the eagle, condor side by side. A spirit stays strong, a spirit don't die. A lot of our youth wanna hang by the neck. What you expect, all you do is neglect. You apologize and you just forget. All you do is talk, come take a step. Six nations, I'ma always rap. Yeah, six nations, I'ma always rap. North to the south, we must connect. East to the west, we must connect. When it comes to the feds, don't trust you yet. Don't hate you, don't love you yet. So enough with the talk, let's see some walk. You like to talk, here's some food for thought. Why do you think that all this exists? You wouldn't let those kids exist. You taught them about hating lies. You taught them about rape and crime. You pushed all that hate inside. So let's teach them that was made to fly. Genocide pain still aching on. 1492, we stay strong. 1890, we ain't gone. 2013, we'll be fighting long. Power to the people, empower the youth. Spread that knowledge so we reach the truth. I know it wasn't us who made this hustle, but we never back down in the face of struggle. Never back down in the face of struggle. Never back down in the face of struggle.
I mean, if you actually know what is in the Indian mind, I mean, if you actually really have read it and know what's in it, it's the most racist form of legislation that exists in the entire planet. It is the most racist.
More white lies do cloud our minds. We gotta open our eyes and realize it's time our people stand up, let's rise. Our time to shine, represent red pride. Onkwehonwe, struggling nationwide. Keep your heads held high, don't forget the past. Cause through tough times we build the last.
My people stand strong throughout the ages. Seven generations overcome the hatred. Welcome to Canada's dark side. Our paw died while heart died. My grandmama, great grandmama, bean for being Kaniki Haka. And just last year she passed. So on her behalf, apology not accepted.
The poison injected, your devil infested. Core systems rejected, our spirits reflected. Our children molested, propaganda subjected. So don't believe the lies, Mother Earth cries. Held us puzzled why, truth never dies. This proof gonna rise, until you realize. Look into my eyes, see the struggle, let it rain. My memories are pain, all pain.
Aboriginal languages in Canada are the most endangered in the world. There's $2 spent per Aboriginal person on revitalizing Indigenous languages. There is over $2,000 spent per person on English and French.
It's too late to apologize. Look at all the pain built up within their eyes. Look at the remorse when the topic strikes. Hundreds of thousands of kids all lost their lives. And the parents couldn't hold their children when it was needed. The priest didn't care, man, without a doubt. They would just scream louder when the children shout. There was forcing and tortures, abortions by the major portions. It's disgusting. What my people face with no sign of caution. Children are meant to be playing and horsing, not to be used up and put into coffins. And it took until 2008 to be brought up in the House of Commons. Just take a look at the faces. Deep down you can feel their hatred, but really can you blame them? That's how they were basically racist. They were little helpless kids asking for the parents while they were all disciplined. Living nothing but honesty and nothing but lies were kept within. To kill the Indian within a child, how the hell can you say that to an innocent smile? They didn't care and let it drag for miles. Guilt and terror kept them building up upon these piles. All of you that went to these schools, you live in proof that heaven actually walks upon these living roofs.
Despite a 2008 apology for the residential schools, the status quo remains. There has been no proper consultations, which the government is obliged to legally uphold, to consult us and to accommodate our concerns, but to also get our consent.
We're a peaceful people, so I say this for my family. There's no need to be rude. Strength is born from tragedy, so we're stronger and we're louder. Love can overcome power. Rape can only bring pain. Pain can only bring sadness. Sadness could bring rage. Rage can only bring damage, but damage could bring change. revolution. Our race was paid no restitution. No food, no land, no resolution. We were beaten, treated like less than human. Our young were molested and executed. But revenge is right there next to losing. I acknowledge that it hurts, like a mother giving birth. Different colors, same earth. People dying over dirt. Eagles crying from the sky. You know there's fire in your eyes, and you can light it with your mind. Be defying of the lies. She's a woman in your eyes, but she's a lion inside. Irrelevant of her size. You couldn't kill her if you tried. But if you take her child, then you take her life. Just think of what it's like.
We cannot live without this planet. We are destroying the planet as we speak. The tar sands, they should not exist. People should be outraged. People talked about outrage. Be outraged because they are killing the First Nations communities that are living around it.
Years gone by, I'm still here, trying to conquer our hearts with hate and fear. Kill the original and the child. This is seventh generation, rebirth is now. Nation's proud, we stand strong. Trying to mold our children, but we moved on. We stood strong, we came as one. Like we did back then, for the poison and guns. Politics and funds and drugs and drugs. Now everybody knows what the country's done. The youth need to know about the past for the future. No longer hidden or forbidden or unspoken. 2008's when the past was a frozen. All around to the line of Onkwehonwe had frozen. Now let's focus on that healing. Teach our children what they're missing. Listen to our elders teaching. Walk that sweet grass road with pride. Wipe those tears you did survive. And those ones who never made it. Lost children is dedicated to you in memory.
And every other person affected by colonization, assimilation, you're not forgotten.
In indigenous cultures, in my culture where the Iroquois Confederacy has upheld the great law of peace, we incorporate how we not only have to respect for ourselves and respect in our relationships with others, but respect for the environment. More Canadians need to find out what indigenous people, not just here in Canada, are experiencing, but throughout this world.